I've been dreaming on in my head like I've seen it. A life worth living is a life with meaning. I'll do what I love till my heart stops beating. I'm feeding this demon. Got a taste, can't erase bitterness in my face. Work a job every day till your dreams fade away. Like a card, never change, play the game that we say. I need a break.
Hi, everybody. I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. Today is Saturday, June 25th, 2022. Since the beginning of the Long Valley swarm of earthquakes, which was Monday, with the magnitude 3.0, there has been a total of 230 earthquakes. In the last 24 hours, there's been 16. They're starting to get deeper, but I wanted to cover the ones that were very shallow. This one today was 1.4 miles above sea level, which is about 7,400 feet above sea level, which means this earthquake was only 481 feet below the surface of Mammoth Lakes. There was a 1.5, which was 5,280 feet above sea level. So that would be 601 feet below the surface. These are very shallow earthquakes. And like I said, some of them are getting a little bit deeper. Here's about 3.3 miles below sea level. But I want to show you something else. Here we have an image of the caldera there at Long Valley. From the surface down to about 5 kilometers is what they call active hydrothermal. So what's going on with these really shallow earthquakes, and this is just my opinion, is that as the rhyolite is coming up, there evidently is some sort of dike intrusion happening. And it's heating this water here. And yeah. So we're getting these earthquakes. You can see here how we got magma coming into the system. And way up at the top there is heated water and gases. Now this earthquake here is the most recent that I have downloaded. At 1759 Universal Time. Comes in as a magnitude 2.0. USGS says it was a 1.6, so they're greatly downgrading these earthquakes again. And you can see here, it's a volcanic earthquake. Yeah, we got rounded tops. This here is what it was showing when I pulled the files. And you can see all this heated water. Well, volcanoes, as the magma comes up, it heats up the water. Once again, I downloaded two different data. From two different sites, MLAC and LRL. This evidently is from a cave. Here's the one monitor right there in the city of Mammoth Lakes. I believe it's at the police station where they might have the monitor, where I put the little monitor on the map. Now that's not accurate for the exact spot. And then the other monitor, let me bring it out, is right over here by Laurel Mountain. I might be wrong, but I believe it's inside some sort of cave over there, and there's the other one at the top. This monitor here, too, I mentioned in my last video, doesn't really pick up the earthquakes that are happening there by the Resurgent Dome. I think because it could be because of the mountain ranges or something. But anyways, we have this earthquake here at 11:17 that they are not reporting. And that comes in as a magnitude 1.84. Then we got another really small one here. Let me see if I can make it bigger. All right, and that probably is small, 1.16. 11:44. That one too, they're not reporting. Let me pull this up over here because there was a lot of magma. I talked about how the magma comes up from the south area, which this monitor is. And you can see here, let me bring this up. Yeah, there was lots of magma coming in. And yeah, now this was a mixture of tectonic earthquakes along with volcanic earthquakes. So as the plates move, and it's close, let me show you this other thing. Just like the Ring of Fire, it's going to have an effect on volcanism. All right, so we got Laurel Creek Fault Zone, and we also got the Convict Creek Fault Zone. And then there's another one, the Hilton Creek Fault. That's a really long, extensive, steep fault that runs all the way up to the Mammoth Lake Resurgent Dome. I have a couple tilt meters I want to show you. It says here, Mammoth Unified School District, Whitmore Springs, Crowley Lake. And let me bring this down so I can show you the tilt meters that's going on. You can see the Resurgent Dome is going up. I don't think the millimeters is correct, because another paper that I found from 2017 stated that there was 20 inches of uplift that had happened all the way up until 2017. Now, this monitor is by Hot Creek, and it shows you the uplift that's going on through this year. And I don't know if I got a date down here at the bottom. Let's see. Yeah, it only goes through to June 23rd. Going back to Google Earth, this is the location of Hot Creek. So this would be the location of the monitor for the uplift. And then going to the station map, right there is the location for this monitor. And we'll bring it down, show you again what it's showing. Back in 1980, they had a magnitude 6.3 earthquake. Let me zoom into this. The purple line is the Resurgent Dome. And yeah, there was a lot of destruction from that 6.3 for the town of Mammoth. This might be why the Mammoth School was torn down, is no longer there. There was also damage to the hatchery, but that was minimal. Supposedly, to the school was minimal, but yeah, you can see it's been torn down. I found a paper about that earthquake. You might find it very interesting. It was estimated to be over $2 million in damage. That was what money was worth back then. And when this article was published, it would have been $6.2 million in damage. I'm not quite sure the date on this paper. Oh, I found it. May 22nd of 2020. There was landslides, rock falls were widespread. Large dust plumes could be seen over the Sierra Nevada immediately following the large aftershocks. There was all kinds of aftershocks. Two hikers in Yosemite Valley, nearly 45 miles away, were severely injured by rock fall. Roads were closed by debris. I wanted to show you this picture here of this boulder. Now, this is about a mile and a half from where the school was located, and this rock came tumbling down, wiped out all the trees, and they got in circles the size of people here. It says, rhyolite boulder that toppled and rolled from the cliff above into an unnamed canyon approximately 1.5 kilometers north-northwest of Mammoth Elementary School. View is to the northeast. The moving boulder knocked down all trees in its path and formed a trail of impact craters, so it must have been bouncing as it rolled down. The craters were about 4 feet to, which is 1.5 meters, to 20 meters deep, or 2 meters deep, excuse me. 6 feet, 7 inches holes that this rock made as it tumbled down, wiping out all the trees in its path. Here's another image of the caldera. And just like Yellowstone, it's got a cap of rhyolite, the most explosive type of gases you can possibly imagine. Here on the right would be southeast, and they believe that there was possible dike intrusion that was causing all those earthquakes back in 1983. Yeah, the magma was coming up towards the south moat. They do not have on here how deep this caldera is, but they do have the width down here in kilometers. And then I wanted to show you the plume, the ash fallout from the Long Valley caldera when it erupted. And there was a pyroclastic flow. And I wanted to show you an area where that occurred. The pyroclastic flow was over 50 kilometers wide. Superheated pumice and ash and rocks about 31 miles in all directions, traveling at about 1,000 miles an hour, was completely wiped out. Everyone and everything would be vaporized. And as you know, any volcano has a chance of erupting with little or no warning. And yeah, the 8,000 people that live in Mammoth, they wouldn't have a chance to escape if it erupted without any warning. Well, we've been getting signs of earthquakes, of unrest. I don't know how long it would take them to evacuate with the different roads, the mountain roads. The last time Long Valley Caldera erupted was 750,000 years ago. When you're on USGS looking at the earthquakes and you see a minus sign, that means it's above sea level. When there's no minus sign, means it's below sea level. So now we're showing a mixture of above sea level and below sea level earthquakes. See, back on the 20th, it was showing signs of this heated water, magma coming into the system, heating up the water. And now that has changed to deeper earthquakes, which means the magma has found a conduit and is coming in a little bit better. Yeah, it's flowing a little bit easier. Let me bring this up to what it's showing right now. See that? Okay, these are all today. We have a total so far of 231 earthquakes since Monday in just 5 days. The most recent was a magnitude 2.0, which would be this earthquake right here. I'm going to try and download it and see if it, in fact, is a 2.0, because it looks bigger to me. All right, it works. Sometimes it doesn't work when I download the data so soon. There's a spectrogram, and it actually comes in as a 2.23, but I shortened up the seismic signature a lot shorter than what it should have been. And then it comes in as a magnitude 2.50. Yeah, usually when you have a swarm, it settles down unless it's trying to recharge and have an eruption. I hope it doesn't. I hope it does settle down. We don't need, it's a big caldera. Not as large as Yellowstone, but just as dangerous. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.